Today, out of all days, you told yourself this morning, man, what a perfect day for cybersecurity. Then it doesn't even matter because you did not say that. Nobody talks like that. But if at some point you just decided one day that you want to learn some cybersecurity, that is awesome. That is perfect because I'm going to share with you the most complete series of tutorials on this topic that you will ever find. And as a nice bonus, I will also prepare you to pass the CompTIA CySA Plus certification exam. Why does this training exist? Well, I made this training because I was just a bit disappointed by the current content that's out there, and I wanted to make something better. Actually, I wanted to make something much better than what you can currently buy from big name training companies. And also, why cybersecurity? Well, first of all, because I personally love it. And secondly, because it's an awesome topic and it's useful for pretty much anyone nowadays who uses a computer or a smartphone. So yeah, basically to anyone. And we are going to need cybersecurity right until, I don't know, forever. It's always going to be relevant because it's everywhere. It's in a non-stop process of change. It's constantly adapting. So if you like cybersecurity and you're even thinking about doing it for a living, your job will always be safe. Well, at least as long as you keep up to date. Another reason is that cybersecurity is supposed to be fun because it's a never-ending strategy game that everybody is playing. The good guys are playing it. The bad guys are playing it. The guys you entrust your money in a bank or when you go shopping. The guys that hold your email and cat videos and TikToks. The guys who make water, light, and pizza, right, to reach your house. And even those guys with tanks, rockets, and drones. So this game should keep you up at night because it's everywhere. It's about your life and you should be passionate about it. Hi, my name is Andrew and I will lead you through this awesome quest on cybersecurity. And if you want, also for the CompTIA CySA Plus exam. So who is this Andrew guy and why does he think that he can teach me something? Well, let me give you two reasons. First of all, my origin story says that I've been working in IT for more than 10 years. And I keep saying more than 10 because the real number kind of makes me feel old. But I also hold this many technical certifications and I will not go over all of these, but have a look over my LinkedIn profile in the description and add me if you want. But suffice to say that I do have some experience with networking, security, and DevOps. And yes, my dear relatives and friends, I am able to fix your computers and routers and printers. Now, the second reason, have a look over the videos in my channel and decide for yourself if I know what I'm talking about. But if I do, please subscribe and help this channel grow because I really need your support as all this content is always going to be free. Free as in free beer, not any other sneaky type of free. So what's in it for you? I will share with you everything that you need to pass the CompTIA CySA Plus exam. And I will also share from my experience and from all my previous certification exams. Because I realized one day after I went through so many certifications and aspects of IT that I've ended up with a very nice perspective of all these topics. And I wanted to share that with you. I want to share which things matter and which things don't, which concepts apply only in books and trainings, and which concepts will make people laugh at you if you want to apply them in real life. And for free. There won't be any paywall, nor no pay-per-view, no demo videos that send you to buy the rest. Everything will be here and free as long as YouTube shall live. Don't trust me yet? Subscribe now and let's see in 10 years who was right. So how are we going to do this? Well, we're going to follow the exam objectives, the official exam blueprint, because this gives us a very nice structure to build our content. You should check out the CompTIA website, download the exam blueprint, but be aware that I will slightly change the order of some topics simply because in my brain, they make a lot more sense that way. So go and have a look over the official page of the CySA Plus exam. There's some very useful information, like the skills that you will learn, some jobs that match this certification, and some exam details, like how many questions you'll get, what's the passing score, and stuff like that. Now, for a detailed list of exam topics, you just need to fill in a form to download the PDF, which, fortunately, I have right here. So we have five domains, or major topics, to cover. We'll talk about threats and vulnerabilities, and how to make some sense of these in a more structured manner. We'll talk about the day-to-day life of someone working in security operations. We'll talk about describing threats, measuring them to know just how badly you could be or have been hacked in the past, how not to freak out if you find vulnerabilities in your systems, and how to find them. Some tools that will help you with scanning and assessments. Some specific threats for things that don't exactly look like a computer. You know, like mobile devices, industrial systems, your PlayStation, Internet of Threats, Internet of Things devices, you know, like smart refrigerators and smart home devices. Moving on to the cloud, because it does have its own set of threats, even though we like to think about the cloud as being something that just works. An entire huge section about types of attacks, and trust me, this is going to be huge, but also very insightful. Then we'll move on to software and systems, like servers and workstations. And this is also where we'll talk about virtualization and containers. Software development and best practices, or how not to develop some piece of code that shoots us in the foot. That's secure coding. Securing low-level hardware against some really nasty and hard-to-detect attacks. Working with specialized devices, like firewalls and IPSs, and quite a few others. About being proactive and looking for threats even when you don't have any proof that you've been compromised yet. Good luck explaining those work hours to your boss. Some newer concepts here about automation because, well, you know the saying, if it's worth doing once, it's worth automating. Moving on to incident response, which is how not to panic when something bad really happens. How to minimize damage and save as much money and as many butts in a compromised company as possible. Learn how to investigate and understand what happened if a cybercrime was committed when the boss comes to you to ask what's happening here, are we under attack, and you go, what? And going a bit deeper and really investigate, you know, like CSI style, in order to, well, if you took a beating, at least learn to defend yourself the next time. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. At least assuming the same type of foolery. And the boring part. Nah, just kidding. It's not boring. It's about policies, compliance, and IT governance, and regulations. Nah, I'm kidding. It is boring, but it's on the exam. About trying to look smart while predicting the future like you have some proof when everybody knows that you don't. Also known as evaluating risk. Then documenting your previous attempt at looking smart. That is, risk assessments. And finally, you should be ready to pass the exam. Now, you might think that is a lot. What did I sign up for? Well, it's a lot because security has never been more complex. There's just so much diversity in everything that's IT around us. Just a little while ago, you only had to secure perhaps your router or firewall so that hackers would not mess around with your website. But today, we have so many devices interconnected, from wearables, phones, smart kitchen appliances, robot vacuum cleaners, which sold like crazy during this pandemic, smart light bulbs, smart cars, smart windows, smart, I don't know, vibrators, and whatever scary smart things might be out there. And this is the new internet. It's also the new playground for hackers. Attacks evolved too. We hear in the media about ransomware, APTs, and many, many more. We also work from home a lot now. And you might say, yeah, but we have VPNs, and that's the definition of security right there. Yeah, but who might have access to your laptop? What other infected devices you might have in your home without you even knowing about them? Because let's be honest, who has enterprise-grade security at home? And even large enterprises get hacked. And by the way, are you even at home or relaxing on some beach in a mountain cabin in some hotel in your parents' home on a wireless network that's so insecure that you shouldn't even watch cat videos on it? So if you're wondering if this exam is right for you or what exactly you should know before starting to study, I would say the requirements are not very high, but you will need some basic computer knowledge and networking concepts before you start. But I would guess that you're probably not attempting the CySA Plus exam if this morning was the first time you ever started the computer. But for more details on exactly how difficult is the exam and what you should expect, keep watching, because this is exactly what we'll be talking about in the next video. So please subscribe and see you next time.